Apple recently released the iOS 17.4 beta. It'll be available for public download in March, and here's every new feature, starting with alternate app stores in the EU. In order to comply with the Digital Markets Act, Apple's allowing users in the EU to download apps outside the native App Store. While developers will have to pay Apple half a euro per user per year, the first million users will be free, and Apple won't take their usual 30% cut of an app's sale price. Also in the EU are third-party browser updates. After updating to iOS 17.4, EU users opening Safari will receive a pop-up that allows them to choose a new default browser, while developers can utilize alternative browser engines like Chrome or WebKit. NFC access is opening up to third-party payment apps in banks in the EU, allowing them to offer contactless payments on iPhone without using Apple Pay or the Wallet app. Moving worldwide, Apple's now allowing streaming game apps on the App Store. That means services like Xbox Cloud Gaming and NVIDIA GeForce Now can now run natively on the iPhone and iPad instead of only being available on the web. There are also new emoji, including a lime, an edible brown mushroom, a phoenix, a broken chain, a nodding head, and a shaking head. The automatically send messages setting under Siri and Search has been renamed Messaging with Siri, and there's an option to allow Siri to read incoming messages in a specific language like Spanish, French, German, Chinese, and more. The Listen Now tabs in Apple Music and Podcasts have been renamed to Home, and the search bar in Safari is now a little bit wider than it was before. In the Stolen Device Protection section of Settings, there's now an option to always require a security delay or only when away from familiar locations. Apple's next generation CarPlay is set to launch in the US later this year, and code in iOS 17.4 references 8 new CarPlay apps, including Car Camera, which displays the rearview camera feed, Charge, which displays battery level, charge status, time remaining until fully charged, and more, Climate, which provides access to a vehicle's climate controls, Closures, which warns of any open doors and other various vehicle warning symbols, Media, which provides access to FM and AM radio station controls within CarPlay, along with other media options like SiriusXM, Tire Pressure, which displays air pressure levels for each of the vehicle's tires and provides low pressure, high pressure, and flat tire warnings, and finally, Trips, which provides a variety of driving-related data, including the vehicle's average speed, fuel efficiency, energy efficiency, and more. It's also likely that CarPlay will display a goodbye screen after the driver shuts off their vehicle. Next, SharePlay Music Control is expanding to the HomePod and Apple TV. Now, a user's family and friends can control the music that's playing on their HomePod or Apple TV after receiving special permission. The stopwatch finally has live activity support, so you can see how much time has elapsed from the dynamic island, then pause or reset it. The How to Watch section in the Apple TV app now shows up as a list rather than a series of cards. The App Store's purchase feature now shows account-wide purchase history for an Apple ID, with apps now being featured in their own section. And finally, there's a new City Digital Clock widget that can be added to the home screen or lock screen. So those are all the new features in iOS 17.4. This is Greg with Apple Explained, and if you want to learn how I make videos like these, let me know by tapping the link in the comments.